Welcome, everybody, and thank you so much for coming. And we're going to just start, as we always do, for this wonderful time where we can send love and gratitude out to the world. Let's take some slow, deep breaths to get into that peaceful, receptive state. So we breathe in slowly and deeply. We hold our breath. We breathe out. Then we hold our breath. Let's do that for a few more breaths. Now let's listen for our heartbeat. Our heartbeat, which is a pulse of light coming down through the silver cord from our mighty I Am presence, anchoring in our heart, giving us life. Let's just see and feel and bless that heartbeat. That heartbeat that anchors into that beautiful 3-4 flame, which is the anchorage of our mighty I Am presence within our physical bodies. Let's just connect with that beautiful flame as we sit in that expanded golden flame in the center, golden yellow flame of wisdom and illumination, perception and discrimination. We see our bodies in this beautiful, dazzling golden flame. To the right, we can see the pink flame, that glorious, dazzling pink flame of pure divine love. And then we see to the left of us that beautiful expanded flame, that sapphire blue, bringing into us the feeling of the will, the power, the faith and the protection from our mighty I Am presence. See and feel and bless this glorious light. Let's take our awareness now up through the top of our head, through the silver cord, to our mighty, beloved I Am presence. Let's see this glorious, all-powerful, all-knowing, all-loving presence smiling down on us. Our wonderful presence of God, I Am. And now we see in the center of our chest a beautiful golden sun forming, dazzling and brilliant like the noonday sun, the beautiful focus of light from our I Am presence. Open our hearts and send love and gratitude to our mighty I Am presence for beating our heart and giving us life. And now we see those rays from our beautiful sun in the center of our chest, dazzling and brilliant, billions and billions of rays going forth and connecting up with each and every miniature sun in all the cells of our bodies, our 4 earthly bodies, all those little inner workers receiving this expanded light. Let's feel the joy, the happiness, and the gratitude of each and every little inner worker of our 4 earthly bodies. Sense and see and feel that wonderful light saturating our earthly bodies. And now let's just fill our feelings with a feeling of love and gratitude. And let's call to the beloved Ascended Masters, beloved Ascended Master David Lloyd, the great God of gratitude, to fill us, each one and all mankind, with this feeling, that light substance, from the Ascended Master realm of gratitude and love. we see our beautiful suns turning a deep shade of pink with a golden radiance. Gratitude and love for all our many, many blessings. Gratitude and love to the great ascended hosts for these marvelous teachings. Gratitude and love for all our loved ones and our friends. Gratitude and love for our homes and our supply. Gratitude and love for all the many, many blessings that we receive daily on our earthly journeys. Gratitude to the great and beloved elemental kingdom, animate and so-called inanimate, the beauty and bounty of nature. God bless, love and thank them, each and every precious one. Gratitude to the beloved angels. And gratitude to all life on our beloved earth. And now we see these rays in this wonderful expanded state, forming a lattice of light, dazzling and brilliant. We see our entire earth folded in this glorious pink and golden light, saturating every part of life on our beloved earth, especially those parts of life that are never loved or thanked, with this wonderful gift, our opportunity of sending love, light, and gratitude to all life. And we just give deep, deep thanks for this. And so we do, just so grateful, just it's in such a beautiful place here at the moment, just at Donna's house, close to Mount Shasta, and it's just so beautiful, and deep gratitude. And beloved Jenny Kling, have you got a screen, beloved? Can you read for us the opening invocation?
I do. Thank you, Anthea.
Thank you.
Before reading the words of the Master, we say together, with mics muted, as suggested by beloved Lord Kuthumi. Beloved presence of God I am, it is thy life and intelligence that enables me to read and comprehend and absorb that which is required of me. For life I am so grateful. Beloved Master Kuthumi, I ask for your feeling and your capacity to use this instruction for God's glory and mankind's comfort. We thank you. And now, great I Am Presence, take me within thyself. There instruct me and cause me to retain the full memory of these inner instructions. Thank you. From beloved Saint Germain. Thank you.
Thank you, beloved Jen. Bless your heart. All right, so we're going, well, Gary's reading, so carrying on with the Magic Presence, the last chapter. We know such an important chapter, that one. And this is beloved Moira continuing with his wonderful dictation. And then we've got a video from beloved Lady Metta, just talking about her beloved father, Sanat Kumara, and his great gift to the world and his sacrifice. Bless him forever, beloved Sanat Kumara. And then Terry's going to read. She's sitting right next to me here, so that's lovely. She's going to read Electronic Patterns, also just a lovely message in there from the beloved Maha Chohan. And then I'm going to read, following on with just gratitude to Sanat Kumara from El Moira, speaking on the great love of Sanat Kumara for this earth and all the people and the life on her. And then John is going to read our decrees for us. He's going to take us through the decrees. So let's just get started now with Gary reading for us.
Chapter 11, the last chapter of the Magic Presence by Godfrey Ray King. The true messenger of divine service, beloved Elmara's brilliant discourse continues. Humanity has almost no understanding of what happens when the personal self sends out a feeling of irritation, anger, hate, envy, jealousy, criticism, or condemnation. The feeling side of human nature is the feminine activity of consciousness within every individual. The thought is the masculine activity of the mind. A thought never becomes dynamic in the outer life until it passes through the feeling body. The feeling condenses upon the thought pattern, the atomic substance of the outer activity of life. In thus passing through the feeling body, the thought becomes clothed and thereafter exists as a separate living thing outside of the individual's mind. There have been platitudes by the million written and preached about divine love being the law of life. But who knows how to generate the feeling of divine love consciously and at will to the limitless degree and put it in the place of irritation, hate, etc., as a wave of actual force and substance, one's own emotional body. Such a thing is not only possible, but must be done if human beings are to stop suffering and express perfection. The personality cannot be permanently harmonious except it be kept filled with divine love consciously generated. If mental statements of the law of life and prayers were the way to perfection, happiness, and freedom, the numbers of sermons preached on this earth should have perfected and illumined 100 planets long before this. If prayers, which by the way are generally a series of wants, I wants, or O Lord give us, were the way to freedom from limitation, the prayers that have been uttered in the world should have perfected a dozen humanities. I do not say that prayers have not brought good, they have, but prayer should be a quieting of the intellect and a stilling of the feeling. That the personality might feel the outpouring of the mighty I Am presence and receive the response from within. Prayer should be an outpouring of the love and gratitude to the presence for the limitless opportunity and good contained within life. The outer world likes to flatter its vanity by the feeling that it has the ability to accomplish great things, but so far as the control and perfection of the feeling is concerned, the outer world is still in a savage state. Human beings sting others as well as themselves through vicious feelings just as surely as it does the scorpion. The predominant feeling in our modern world is terrifically vicious when personalities are opposing and criticizing those who disagree with them. So-called civilized people commit murder every day of the week through sending out angry and irritated feelings that kill the higher impulses in others. It is the feeling of the race that needs to be redeemed and saved from its own self-generated destruction until the individual understands the need of self-control in regard to his feeling in the waking consciousness. It is impossible to maintain any permanent forward movement of a constructive nature. All accomplishment that is not attained through the feeling of divine love is but temporary, for divine love alone is the way to permanent perfection. It is pitiful to see how, for centuries, the human race has occupied its time and used its energy to build upon things through thought, and that at the same time tear its creations to pieces by inharmonious feelings. It is childish and a stubborn refusal to fulfill the eternal plan of perfection.
Such brilliant words from beloved Omoira. All right, now we're going to listen to this wonderful, wonderful video. Actually, Terry's reading, but it's from Lady Metta. Just so lovely.
Address by beloved Ascended Lady Master Metta. Introduction. Our love and gratitude extends to our Lord, Sanat Kumara, beloved Venus, and the Lady Master Metta, their daughter of light. May all who read it find inspiration to become a part of that great brotherhood, whose service is to learn to consciously generate and project the light rays, which dissipate the evils created by mankind before mankind themselves have to reap the imperfect harvest they have sown. Blessed Metta, your activities in the focusing of conscious students in the etheric cities has preserved mankind to this present day. We call now that unascended beings may open their consciousness, hearts, and beings to these light rays and become spiritual partners with your trained students who serve at inner levels. We call also that every chela may master the magnetization and direction of the light rays whenever and wherever needed to remove distress and to bring peace, healing, protection, enlightenment, and God control to their fellow men. Thomas Prince. Sanat Kumara's Sacrifice by Beloved Metta, Daughter of Sanat Kumara. Beloved sons and daughters of God, I bring to you the particular and specific benedictions of Sanat Kumara, my blessed father, and the beloved Venus, my holy mother. I bring you also the blessings of all the ladies of heaven who are particularly interested in your endeavors to expand the radiation of healing through sustained harmony in your feelings. It is many, many centuries, as recorded by human time, since my father returned from a conclave of the sons of the system. I remember, as though it were yesterday, the day he divulged the information to my mother and our family, that through cosmic vote and through divine justice of the impersonal universal law, the planet Earth had lost the right to draw any more energy or to be further sustained by the self-conscious sacrifice of elemental life. Neither was it longer entitled to receive the release of substance, power, and light from the sun, from the angelic host and those other beings who had guarded her thus far. It was thought by the cosmic law to be the part of wisdom and justice to return this earth again to the unformed, to primal life, that its substance might be repolarized and formed anew in the womb of some future sun, to be cradle for some other evolution, perhaps more willing and desirous of fulfilling the will of God. My mother, as you know, feeling the love within my father's heart for the beloved earth and its evolution, gave him full freedom to offer his light and his love to sustain the planet if the cosmic law would accept his offer of assistance. Therefore, he went to the cosmic authorities of this system with a joyous heart, proffering his help, and as you are aware, his gift of love and sacrifice was accepted. It was not long thereafter that the first group of volunteers left Venus to prepare a place for him on the earth, a place befitting his great rank and his great and mighty service to this planet and the universe. These endeavored in every way to recreate the atmosphere which he knew and loved so well upon our star, Venus. Then came the day when he himself was to take leave of our planet, to take leave of its people and us, and to rise into the atmosphere over Venus, as he had so often done before. However, this time, he passed out beyond the periphery of our sphere of influence and entered into habitation in the atmosphere of Earth. All through the history of Venus, the Kumaras had ascended into the atmosphere of the star on great occasions, such as cosmic feast days or at times when they wished to address all the population of the globe at one time. Like stars blazing in the firmament, they were able to direct an address that would envelop the planet through radiation, through color and spiritual telepathy. This message would then be received by each individual in his own locality. Therefore, our people were neither surprised nor startled to see the great Sanat Kumara ascend into the heavens above our star. Only a few of us, the immediate family, the council, the priests and priestesses of the temples, only these knew that the being ensouling the light above our star would shortly begin a journey which would take him from our home and planet for a period which we thought, at the most, would be of but a few centuries' duration. Sanat Kumara was the embodiment of all our hope and love, the greatest being evolved upon the star. It has been a long, long time that the Queen of Love has reigned alone, acting as man and woman, as father and mother, to an evolution so magnificent and so beautiful that discord of any kind is unknown in her realm. Not one electron drawn from the universal has ever been qualified imperfectly there by angel, elemental, or the evolution which is parallel to the divinely matured expression of your humankind. Each life stream on Venus, each newborn soul and spirit, attains and develops mastery in absolute harmony. That too was the design for your beloved Earth, and is the design of the Father of all light and love for every planet and star in the entire universe. The Earth forgot this, not because of her people themselves, but because of the contamination they absorbed through radiation and contagion from the polluted consciousnesses of those who came here from other stars, to whom she, the Earth, had previously extended hospitality, that they might complete the evolution which they had neglected in their native spheres. Because the Earth in herself is sweet, because her evolving peoples are fundamentally harmless, and because the guardian spirits who came from other stars and planets to serve and sacrifice like unto that of my Father have served well, the great cosmic law has allowed more than ordinary assistance to be given this small planet at this time. Thus, beloved ones, we continued on Venus without the presence of our King for a long, long period of time, and finally my mother suggested that I come here to give the assistance of my love and light until the victory of the Earth was assured. We had, of course, visited this sphere many times, having accompanied groups of envoys from Venus who entered the Earth's atmosphere on various occasions. The joyous intercourse, therefore, that existed between our planet and yours gave us a certain freedom and, of course, all through the ages after my father's departure from Venus, we were in constant communication with the beloved exiles. However, you can see that this is not exactly the same as using the energies of your being to serve on a planet of your own choice and evolution. May I say then, just in passing, that we offer our extreme and personal gratitude to you, each and every one, who are interested in the cause of Sanat Kumara. Do you realize that for many centuries even his precious name was unknown to the mankind of Earth? Yet when man hears that name, he invariably feels a thrill of happiness within his heart. I need not describe the sensation to you, for each of you felt it when the name of Sanat Kumara was first brought to your attention, either through worded expression or the written page. And we, who are serving life to set him free, we, who are endeavoring to help the Earth complete her course of evolution, are grateful to you, grateful beyond all words to describe, for your interest and your sweet cooperation in our cause.
Oh, wow. Anyway, that's just such a lovely thing to focus on. Deep, deep love and gratitude to beloved Sanat Kumara, Lady Venus, and all the ones from Venus that have assisted our planet. How blessed are we? And now, beloved, Terry's going to read electronic patterns, and I'm going to get it up on the screen. Get it up here. Thank you, Terry.
Thank you, beloved. Hello, everyone. This is an address by beloved Maha Chohan. Beloved children of my heart, the great creator in his multiple mercy and kindness created the electronic pattern of each individual different and distinct so that all might enjoy a certain individuality and beauty of form. The electrons of each such individual differs in their elemental structure like unto the snowflakes. Each pattern and form represents the identity of the I Am Presence, which will manifest through the Holy Christ Self in its fullness through the outer self as the three become one, the Holy Trinity. As you have been often told before, the pattern of the electron of Ascended Master Saint Germain is represented by the Maltese cross. That of Lord Gautama Buddha is the open lotus. That of the beloved regent, Sanat Kumara, is the perfect star of love and peace. This means that all of the electrons which make up Sanat Kumara, beloved Saint Germain, and the Lord Gautama's bodies are countless myriad replicas of the forms mentioned above, through which the light of God always flows in the prismatic colors of the rainbow. All the God energy that they draw from the body of God, the unformed, once it has come under their conscious control, is immediately stamped with these patterns and wherever it proceeds in the universe, directed by their thoughts, feelings, spoken words, and actions, these electrons will carry the outline of their particular pattern. In like manner, all the God energy which each chela draws from the unformed immediately takes on the form of his or her own electronic pattern. This is how, as the energy proceeds in its circular activity and returns, following the law of the circle, to you with added power, that there is a selective intelligence by which the divine beings are enabled to assist. To assort, so to speak, the emanations of mankind one from the other. The energy drawn from the universal God, I Am, which is a voluntary activity, comes into the use of the outer consciousness, who dispenses that energy freely in thought, feeling, spoken word, and action. The personal self does not always see that energy, nor his mark of ownership upon it, and feels that he can send forth that energy indiscriminately without rendering an account thereof. Every thought form, feeling form, word, and activity of the outer self carries that stamp which identifies the energy with the person who drew it forth, qualified, and expended it. This moves in a circle and returns to its source for redemption, bringing with it other energy of its kind. At all of the places on earth where the elect have sought God and achieved their victory, they contain yet much of the essence of that individual, and it is conducive to the raising of the consciousness of all seekers. For instance, the place where the Lord Gautama Buddha received his illumination is so spiritually charged with the cosmic lotus symbol of his life stream that all who come into the vicinity feel a definite effect from his consciously drawn radiation. If every serious chela would daily charge the so-called inanimate objects in and around him with the violet transmuting flame, he would one day be amazed how even those things he has discarded can and will be a spiritual impetus to soul. He knows not of the radiation charged into them by the pure electrons of his own life stream. Service should always be so universal
and daily living can make talismans out of every form loaned to you for the enrichment of all life. Some chelas are particularly sensitive to the blessing of the inanimate form and the nature kingdom, and it is well to encourage one's talents along these lines.
Marvelous. Thank you, beloved Cherry. And that's just so lovely. I just always think of that wonderful dictation given by the beloved Maha Chohan, also about blessing everything that we throw away, because everything is conscious and intelligent and loves to be loved and thanked, all evolving as we all are, reaching higher and higher. So bless all the life, the so-called inanimate life, because it's all life. And now we're going to just end the screen here. All right, so this is lovely. This came because every week I subscribe to the Findhorn Foundation. They send out these lovely messages that Eileen Cuddy received when she was still alive. And, you know, she was the one that founded Findhorn along with her husband and others, that marvelous place in northern Scotland. And anyway, so I just loved this week's one, and I just thought it would be nice for us to read what she was given. So this is what she was given. These are crucial times, and each soul is needed in its rightful place. It is like a vast jigsaw puzzle being put together. There is a right place for every tiny piece. Are you in your rightful place? Only you will know. Do you feel you blend in perfectly with the whole and that you do not create any jarring or discordant note? Peace, harmony, and tranquility must be within you to stabilize you and bring you into alignment with that what is about to take place. Therefore, it is necessary to be still and find that peace within so that nothing and no one can disturb it. Be like an anchor, strong and steady, so that no storm without can affect you or shift you from your rightful place. Hold fast and know that all is very, very well, and that all is proceeding according to my perfect plan. Let not your heart be troubled, but put your whole trust, faith, and security in me, which we know is our mighty I Am presence, and the great ascended ones assisting us. I just thought it was so lovely. And as we know, we're continually reminded by the ascended ones to maintain that harmony. And we get tested, we get put in all these situations which test us, because without the test, how do we know if we are master? All right, so now we're going to say this lovely decree that we have, and we manage it every week to say it, to help all our brothers and sisters that have left their physical bodies and are caught in the astral realms. So we say it together. Beloved presence of God, I am in me, beloved immortal, threefold flame of eternal truth within my heart, and beloved Saint Germain, while my body sleeps this night, let all the constructive energy of my entire life stream, including that in my causal body, be used to render whatever service is needed in the violet flame temples established in the psychic and astral realms to draw the full gathered cosmic momentum of the violet purifying flame of divine love and compassion through every discarnate life stream there. Let all the souls who dwell in those realms be drawn into those purifying temples of mercy and compassion, and there have the accumulated destructively qualified energies of their life streams purified and transmuted, so that when they are summoned for re-embodiment by the Lords of Karma, they bring into incarnation only a heritage of perfection and carry in their life streams no miscreations that would add to their own or the world's distress. We accept this done now with full cosmic power, and so be it, beloved I Am, and we thank you. Thank you. Okay, this is just lovely. This is a very unusual friendship, and it's just so lovely to see how all the different species just love each other, regardless, once they're friends from the beginning. It's a beautiful story. I think you'll enjoy it.
This is the story of Kumbali and Kago, a cheetah and a Labrador, who became the best of friends. Kumbali was the smallest and weakest cub in his litter. The zoo staff were concerned about his health as he wasn't gaining weight. Therefore, they decided to save his life by taking him under their care. But beyond physical health, it was important to teach the young cheetah how to be a cheetah, especially since he couldn't live with his family. The solution was found in Kago, a Labrador puppy rescued from a shelter. It is known that friendship with dogs helps cheetahs become more confident. Their first meeting was touching. The zoo staff decided to give this a chance. Initially cautious, Kumbali gradually softened under the fearless and playful Kago's approach. Soon, they began playing together, and their friendship quickly strengthened. Day by day, Kago and Kumbali learned from each other. The cheetah showed how to run fast, while the Labrador taught him that the world wasn't as scary as it seemed. When Kumbali was tired, he loved to curl up to sleep, embracing his new friend. Their friendship was special. As time passed, Kumbali grew stronger, but their games continued. They ran and rejoiced in life together, regardless of the differences in species and size. Their friendship became an example for many, reminding us of the importance of accepting differences and the value of true friendship. Kumbali and Kago taught everyone who saw them that real friendship knows no boundaries or prejudices. Each time the zoo staff observed these two, they saw not just a cheetah and a dog playing together, but a symbol of harmony and understanding. This story is not just about a cheetah and a Labrador, it's a tale about the power of friendship, capable of changing the perception of the world. Kumbali and Kago have become a reminder that friendship can arise in the most unexpected places and circumstances.
So lovely, and also so just so comforting to know that there's people helping all those animals caught in zoos and bringing them into a place where they can be happy. And so now we have this opportunity to say our decree for all our beloved animals, insects, and reptiles. And we say together, beloved, I am presence of all mankind. Charge your mighty light of mercy and compassion to flow through us all and bring comfort to the animal, insect, and reptile kingdoms. May each human being remember and accept their responsibility as guardians and protectors of this planet's pure and innocent life until all is set free and their divine plans fulfilled. We so decree it and so be it. In God's most holy name, I am. We accept it done and we thank you. Thank you, thank you. Now I'm going to read. This is always stirs me because I often read it in the workshops. It's such a wonderful, wonderful piece from beloved Elmira on the great selfless love and the great sacrifice that our beloved Sanat Kumara gave, and his love for all humanity is just so beautiful. So he says, what consciousness would stand at the fall of every golden age before the karmic board and say, I renew my vow, I shall remain, they will yet arise, they will yet emit light. The karmic board more than once counseled him to linger no longer, that the mercy of the law had exhausted itself, that divine justice would no longer accept a sacrifice of such tremendous proportions of love without parallel. I have stood there, you have stood there, as this great dignified Lord of life quietly and firmly said, I shall remain. Then the light of Venus dimmed in his eye and the thought of home receded from his sweet consciousness, lest the very pull of that love would weaken his resolve. I have stood on Venus by the side of Sanat Kumara's beloved. I have seen her filled with increasing hope as the hour of his exile neared completion. Then I have seen her turn and walk back into the city of the sun with her shoulders squared and her eyes facing the heart of the presence, another million years doing the work of others. That, my children, is love. That is what fires me with enthusiasm, with determination to find among sons and daughters of men some who would love as Venus has. That is the inspiration that brought me to the side of Saint Germain. That is the fire that took me into the very presence of Helios and Vesta themselves, to ask for an opportunity to reach those chelas who had served with me in many a tight corner through the ages. That is the fire that beat within my heart, as I stood before the great Maha Chohan, and in the face of his question made me say, I believe I can find men and women to hold the bridge, to fan the dying embers of truth, to stir the souls of men, to set this God being free. Justice and right must prevail. Men and women who have benefited by the patience and love of Sanat Kumara, who yet refuse to serve when they know what he has done, it is outrageous. This is a crusade, my dear ones, in which my spirit, my soul, the very fire of my being is invested. And before I am through, there will be not one soul on this planet who has not heard the name of Sanat Kumara. There will be not one incoming soul who will not kneel before his light. I ask the Lords of Karma to withhold a physical body from any life stream who is to come through the gates of birth until that soul agrees to use its energies, to emit the light which sets that great being free. I am a man of determination and purpose. It is the will of God that the men and women of earth give forth that light to make this star shine. At inner levels, it is a disgrace to look upon the sweet earth, to hear its cry, to hear its groan as it turns upon the axis, and to witness the effluvia from the hearts of men that the blessed elementals are forced to clean up. Come forth now, my friends. Let us be about our Father's business. I thank you, beloved Almora, and just so be it. Just always so wonderful. And as we know, it was in January of 1956 that beloved Almora was able to go back to his great beloved family, Sanat Kumara, beloved, sorry. But I said Almora, sorry. Sanat Kumara went back to Venus, and apparently the celebration was something to behold. There is an account of it, and in the British Freedom material, and just so blessed. But he did choose to come back. He chose to come back in the 1970s and to assist beloved Saint Germain at this critical time. And as we told, he came back to lift the curse of Cain and the sweat of the brow from humanity. And he's still in embodiment in Indonesia. He chose to embody in Indonesia. But he has also told that this year he needs to return to Venus. So who knows what's going to happen, but God bless his holy name forever. And I thought we'd sing to beloved Sanat Kumara on the strength of that. God bless him. So we're going to swap the share here. Ah, lovely to be able to sing to beloved Sanat Kumara. God bless him forever. Thank you. Beloved John will take over now. Thank you so much, John.
Thank you, beloved. Now we say together a decree for the world. Mighty Omnipresence, great host of ascended masters, archangels and Elohim, cosmic beings and great cosmic light, come forth now in all your cosmic power. Withdraw and withhold all power from destructive forces and individuals with destructive intent throughout the world, right now and forever, whether it is conscious or unconscious. Expose, seize, bind, and render helpless all these sinister forces and their activities until the light has removed them completely, and illumine the source so this may never act again. Raise up to positions of power the divinely chosen leaders. Replace all with ascended master consciousness and the divine plan fulfilled. We thank you. Cube of Light Protection. Beloved Mighty I Am Presence, beloved Archangel Michael, beloved Commander Comrade, continually intensify your protective pillar of pure light substance and Archangel Michael's armor of light through and around me, charged with your invincible protection, all-powerful and impenetrable. I am invisible. I am invincible. I am invulnerable to anything but thy almighty perfection. I am grateful we are given whatever added protection is needed. And what we ask for ourselves, we ask for our loved ones, and that which is constructive in all mankind and the world. We thank you. Now we take some time to visualize, see, and feel this mighty cube of light, full of that brilliant crystal and blue light surrounding each and every one of us from our beloved mighty I Am Presence. That light that instantly deflects anything not of the light. See it blazing brightly around our homes, families, loved ones, around this group, around every constructive life stream across the face of the earth. God bless, direct, perfect, and protect each and every one. We thank you. Now by the fire decree, Mighty Am Presence, beloved Saint Germain and those ministering to the Violet Flame, come forth now and blaze your cosmic violet fire and cause a mighty victory for all the world to see. I am the law of forgiveness in cosmic action now. I am the victory of the sacred fire in all its cosmic power. Mighty angels descend with your purple wands of fire and strike them into the center of every place where there has been a history of sinister force activity. Transmute and consume it all, cause, core, record, effect, and memory, and set it all free from that which was never meant to be. Replace it all with ascended master consciousness and the divine plan fulfilled, and we thank you. decree for the elementals. I am the light of God that never fails, purifying, loving, thanking, and blessing the great directors of the elemental kingdom and every beloved earth, water, air, and fire elemental for your ceaseless service to me and to all mankind. I am the mighty cosmic light, awakening all mankind to the great intelligence of this kingdom, and remove from elemental life today the necessity for longer obeying the destructive impulses of mankind. And so be it, beloved I am, we thank you. In the name of my mighty I Am Presence, great cosmic beings and great cosmic light, I decree, I am the presence charging the minds and feelings of everybody in America and the world, the Saint Germain's ascended master consciousness and perfection, right now and forever. I am the presence blessing, illumining, perfecting, and setting all free in service to the light. Beloved cosmic I Am Presence and great goddess of liberty, direct the cosmic light of liberty as of a thousand suns into the cause and core of anything attempting to delay the divine plan of the great white brotherhood for the earth's eternal freedom, and release us from all tyranny here and now. So be it, beloved I Am, we thank you. I am the most intensified cosmic action of the flame of divine justice, blazing throughout the world, right now and forever. I am the law. I am the justice. I am the judge. I am the jury. Knowing that I am all powerful, then I know that only divine justice can be done everywhere, here and now. Beloved Lady Portia, ensure divine justice prevails throughout the world, right now and forever. And so be it, and so it is, and it is done. Beloved I Am, we thank you. Now, before saying our final our victory, the light decree, we call to you, beloved mighty victory. We demand mighty victory's heart flame become a garment about us, become a wall of invincible protection around us, become illumination within us, become all of everything we require to produce victory everywhere, forever. We say together, I am the victory of the light. I am the victory of the light. I am the victory of the light. I am the cosmic flame of victory, which reigns supreme everywhere, right now and forever. We accept these calls answered as they are made, according to thy will, with full cosmic power, maintained and doubled each instant of each hour, until fully manifest. And so be it, and so it is, and it is done. Beloved I Am, we thank you. Now we'll make our call to the secret love star. We end off with that wonderful feeling of divine love as we make our calls to the secret love star. That tremendous focus of cosmic divine love from the great central sun shining in the heavens for the next 2000 year period. Supreme light that can never be requalified by human thoughts or feelings. By the power of our beloved and mighty I Am Presence, we say to all human creation, all misqualified thoughts, feelings, and actions, you have no power. You have no power. You have no power. Your end has come. By the power of our mighty I Am Presence, we invoke those pink and golden rays from the secret love star. We command that they go forth, saturating all life on this earth in that substance from the secret love star, that supreme light that clears any and all imperfections, limitations, inharmony of any kind and fills every cell, atom, and electron of our four earthly bodies with feelings of love and adoration. Feelings of immense gratitude and reverence for life, kindness, tolerance, charity, grace, unity, brotherhood, and goodwill, one holy family. Beloved secret love star, make each and every one of us a living sun of pure divine love, radiating centers of pure unconditional divine love, so we may bless all those we interact with, every place we visit, and whomever we pass by. We send our deepest love and gratitude to the mighty beings of light who maintain and sustain this great focus of love. We are most grateful and we give our deepest thanks for this and the opportunity of adding our light to these calls. Thank you, beloved I am. Thank you, everybody. Blessings to all.
Lovely. Thank you, beloved John. Absolutely marvelous. Oh, wonderful. And so there we have it. Now we've just got to do the closing invocation. And just not quite sure who's got the screen, but I'm just thinking, Jenna Smith, beloved, are you available to read for us?
I am. Yes, I am. And let's do it. Before ending the session, we all say with our mics muted, beloved I am presence and beloved Master Kathumi, nourish the seeds planted in my consciousness so that the ideas entrusted to me become manifest flowers of perfect expression in my world and the world of all my fellow men. Beloved presence of God, I am, pour the light of thy great glory upon my consciousness and nourish the seeds planted by the masters. And we thank you so much.
Lovely. And we do thank you so much. Thank you so much, beloved Jenna. And then let's just take a moment just to open our hearts and just send love and gratitude to our I presence, to our holy Christ selves, to the great ascended masters, all the angels, the elementals, just love and gratitude, and to beloved Sanat Kamara too, and our blessed Saint Germain. Thank you, thank you, thank you, everybody. Just going to stop the recording.